people of the internet, and welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, welcome to our apartment. Obviously, you can tell by the title of this video, this is our apartment tour. We have been living here for almost a year and a half. It's about a year and 5 months. We are moving in
next month.
My lovely girlfriend, if you guys have never been to this channel, this used to be our channel together.
Hi.
This is Kayla.
Hi.
And she is going to be my plus one tour guide for this apartment tour.
I mean, I live here, so it'll be my apartment tour.
Just yours. Welcome to Kayla's crib, guys.
Welcome to my crib. So, this is the front hall. You saw us in the video earlier.
In the front hall.
This is the other angle of the front hall.
That's the angle.
So there's
we
the
were
door.
At.
Oh. Here's the angle without us standing. Our little mailboxes.
P&K. KMJ.
We have our pride flag here.
Very nice.
Our shoes. Some bags hanging. Key rack.
Who installed this beauty?
I believe that was Tess.
Yes.
Yeah. And then she likes to hang her purse there. And there's a bag rack right here.
There were coats here for the longest time. So yes, we can move it.
This is a nice rug, and we got it at a flea market. And we liked it a lot. $25 maybe. Yeah. And then we have over here this thingy.
What do we call it?
We literally call it the thingy.
The white thing.
Yeah. It just holds a bunch of stuff.
Little knickknacks.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, sunglasses are pretty important over here. Use those. This flower is from a funeral of a family member. Then we have poop pads. Not to wipe your butt with, but to make notes. We'll come over here, and this is the hallway. So this is the bathroom. I had this open because we have a stain on our curtain that I didn't want you to see. But then someone shut it. I'm not sure, it must have been Peter or something. But we'll just keep it closed for now. Sink, medicine cabinet slash mirror, little basket of towels, another basket of towels. Got this nice little hutch here with another mirror. Some toiletries. That's pretty much the bathroom.
This person lives with me. She's gonna introduce you to the bedroom.
This is where all the magic happens.
Okay, we're not doing that.
Welcome to our bedroom, guys. This is our bedroom. This is what it looks like right when you walk in. This is our laundry basket. We actually just bought this. We got it from TJ Maxx. This guy has been with us through all of our apartments, but we just got a new, well, we didn't just, but a while ago we got a new base, and I think it looks a lot better. This is my side of the bed, guys. This is everything that I need throughout the night, the day, whenever I'm laying on my side of the bed. Here I have a little box that smells like wood, and I'm obsessed with it, especially when you open it up. My grandparents got this for me. I believe it's from China. We have this little guy from IKEA. He's not real. We have a little salt lamp here that we use. Sometimes we mostly use the twinkle lights at night, but if it's too bright at night, we'll use the salt lamp because she is not that bright. If you move down here, there used to be a door on this thing. This beautiful side table my parents got me when I lived with them, and I am obsessed with it. But it used to have a door on it, and I don't know where the door went. I don't know when it fell off. In my little cabinet lives some of the books that I like. A book that I got from my parents. I don't know if you guys can figure out which book in there that one is. But I have a couple journals in there, and then this is the current book that I'm reading. I started it a long time ago, and I never finished it. So I am reading it again. It's called You Are a Badass, and I've heard amazing things about it. And then in here, this, we had a partnership with Yod, their watch company. I used the packaging to hold some electronic stuff. So this is our dresser. It's usually not this clean, I will be honest. Ideally, we like to have it this clean. This over here is where we keep all of our loose change, and then in this guy I got from my grandmother, my great-grandmother. It's a little change purse. We put all of our quarters in it, and then we bring this downstairs to do laundry. This is like our junk drawer for our bedroom, basically. We have this little record store down the street from our apartment, and that's where we get all of our incense. So this is a little, this is an old, what do you call this thing?
Spice jar.
Yeah. This is an old spice jar that we took the, what did we take off of it?
Lid?
No! the label.
Yeah, we took the label off, and this is where our incense live. And then this.
It's where what lives?
Our incense. This guy is one of my favorite things ever. I got it on a trip. It's a little, we got it at this pottery place in, where did we go?
Maine.
Do you want to
talk? Do you know anything?
No. Usually it has sage in it with a lighter, but we threw our sage out because it wasn't working. I don't know how sage doesn't work, but right now it's holding bobby pin. This little guy my brother gave me, he's a little lucky cat. And then this little birdie is part of a bluebird family that my mother has at her house, and I have my little bird. The rest of them live at her house. And then this guy here is a little ornament from my grandmother who passed away's ornament collection. And I got this one because my grandmother taught me how to sew, and we used to sew together. So I love this little guy. So this little corner is where our bags live, backpacks, things that we use on a daily basis. This mirror has been with me my entire life. It's lived on this basket since we moved here. So K&J gave us this guy as a gift for Christmas. What I love about it most is that they didn't know, they were concerned on whether or not they got the date right after getting it made off of Etsy. And yeah, we were established in 2013, so.
Not Peter. He wasn't born yet.
No, he wasn't born yet. Yeah. Then we'll move on to our hat wall. My hat line, I guess I should say. I saw this idea on Instagram and I was like, I have to create this for myself because I own a lot of wide brim hats. That's how a lot of people know me. So this is where my wide brim hats live. And I think it looks pretty cute. And then this guy, he keeps us cool in the summertime. That's all I gotta say about him. And then this is one of my favorite spots in our entire apartment. It has a very sentimental items on it. This guy up here, my cousin made. We had mentioned that we liked it when we went over to her house before, and she thought it was one of the most awful creations she had ever made, but we thought it was so cool, so we had her sign it, and she gave it to us. These little clipboards hold some pretty great things. This over here is from a book that I had created when Kayla and I were not living together. The book had old flowers that we would give each other in it, and this is one of the pages after I think we may have gotten rid of the book, but this was one of the pages in it. This is a picture K&J took of us. I don't remember what we were doing. And then this here is from a trip that we took. This is our first Christmas card. I think Kayla used it as a bookmark for a while. And then under here is from a trip to Austin that we took with our friends. And then this is a card that I gave Kayla when we were living long distance or dating long distance. Down here is something that I made. If you can name the quote that this is from, thumbs up to you, because I love this quote. And I think this is just a badass painting.
I agree.
This is the book we're reading together at the moment. This is our diffuser that my mom gave Kayla for Christmas. This is another fake plant. I feel like none of the plants that we own would thrive in our bedroom, so that's why we have fake plants in our bedroom. And then this is our Alexa. She never is plugged in because Kayla doesn't like her being plugged in. So this is our bed frame. In our last apartment, we lived down the street from this warehouse, and we saw that they had wooden pallets like in the garbage all the time. I had called the sign on the warehouse and I was like, can I take one of your pallets? But the guy who answered was like, nobody ever asks, they just take the wooden pallets, so please like take as many as you want, and so we did. So it's not attached to the bed or anything. Our Christmas lights live on that guy, and then this is a dream catcher that I bought when I went to Vegas with my friends from Italy. This is the same like bedspread that we've had all throughout living together. So
including that cat.
Yeah, she's part of it. I forgot to talk about these. Come back. So this is a frame. I don't remember where I bought it, but these guys I'm obsessed with. I got them from a little boutique here in Milwaukee. And they are just little positive quotes. And then this guy here is from a dinner that Kayla and I had. This guy up here, Kayla's aunt had it up on her wall in her house and wanted to replace it with something else. And we had said that we liked it, so she literally gave it to us. And that was super sweet of her. And I think it really goes with our vibe of our bedroom, one, but like our vibe of our life, because like we love to travel and it literally just fits in so perfectly, like it was meant to be here. Oh, before we leave, T and K, those have been there since what, the beginning? Yeah, the beginning. So that's our bedroom.
This is my son.
Hey, Mevy.
This is my baby.
All right, so straight on from the front door, which is right behind you, is our living room slash family room, whatever you want to call it. Let's head on in. This is one of my favorite rooms in the apartment besides our bedroom. And the reason being is because it's so comfortable. So right when you walk in, we have a little basket for blankets. We have Peter's throne. Legit, this blanket lives on here for Peter so he can take a nap. And then we have our beautiful peace lily that I got from my grandmother's funeral. And then this rug, I believe, is from Wayfair. I don't know who's gonna take it when we move out because all four of us bought it together and I think we all really like it, so I don't know. This table is K and J's. Got a little marble slab on it with our orchid. We don't know how she's doing, but she still got green leaves, so we heard that that's okay. We got our little Buddha head, which is so freaking heavy, and his little top knot has fallen off many a time. Going this way, our television. The television stand is from Wayfair as well, and all of the little wooden animals around the apartment, most of them were my grandmother's. She collected wooden animals, so everyone in the family got ones that kind of like pertain to their life or that they just liked. Like, I always liked this guy. I thought he was just so weird and interesting, and I love how he sits off the side of a surface. This lamp from my parents. This table, funny story, my uncle gave to us with another rug that's in our apartment. After we took it home, he had sent me a text saying that it has to come back because it's his wife's like mother's or aunt's or something, like it's a sentimental table, and we keep forgetting to bring it back. So when we move, Uncle Matt, we promise we will somehow get your table back to you. Our beautiful blue IKEA couch, pillows from like TJ Maxx or Marshall's or something. And then back here, we have this painting. My aunt is an artist, and my parents bought this little frog for me from one of her art shows because I used to love painting frogs myself, and I just loved this guy. And then this, where did we got it from an antique mart. This is our little wooden half ladder, and it holds some of our throw blankets. And then Jay and I put this wall up. It is a collection of all of our artwork. For instance, like these two pieces are K and J's. We have two photos of both couples here. This guy is hanging on for dear life. We need a new frame for him. But this is the skyline of Chicago, colored with colored pencil in rainbow color that Kayla drew for me when we were long distance. And it's one of my favorite pieces she's ever drawn for me. So I love this one. This, I could not find the heart to recycle. This was found in our pocket doors in our apartment when we moved here, and our pocket doors would not close because of this. And I felt like it needed to stay in the apartment because it was already living here. So this will go on to a new apartment. I love this piece. I think that's it for this room.
Mine in the den, my favorite room in the house, just because it's just so bright and calm, I would say. So here we have K and J's couch with their pillows, our nice little hanging tree plant thing, along with the other one. We like how they look when they're hanging. They're both fake. A little yoga slash exercise section. Got some weights, DVDs here. This table that Tessa's father made. And then over here we have some pictures. Cool little picture holder thing. And a desk with a bunch of stuff on it. This cat tree, probably my favorite.
Yeah, you get to play on it a lot.
Yeah, so I scratch my paws on this, and then I get up on the big tower, play with the ball. get my hair all over it.
Oh wait, that's YouTube.
But this tree, I refuse to call it a plant because it's a freaking tree.
Was given to us by Tessa's parents.
This one's real.
Yes. And then this blue chair.
It's black.
It's not black.
Is very comfortable. I actually fell asleep in it last night. Tess was sitting in that futon and I was sitting here and we meditated, and after we were done, Tess was on her phone and I just legit fell asleep. It was great. And I feel like falling asleep now. I love these windows. These windows were my favorite part in the den.
Yeah.
I just love, even how it looks from the outside, it actually reminds me of the Full House house. That's a whole different thing, but like, I just like it a lot. That little plant over there, my favorite in the house, that Tess won't let me transfer to a new pot unless I learn how.
I don't want you to kill it.
Yeah, I won't. I'll probably just do it on my own.
She's killed one of our plants by repotting it.
I think it was by overwatering. Thank you. Let's get it straight. And then Tessa's little succulent.
Oh, I love the succulent.
She grew from a little pod, like a little, what are they called?
Yeah, it was like these.
Mm-mm.
What?
No, it was like a little seed, basically. It was like a little sprout. Remember?
Was it? No.
Yeah, it was not one of these. I promise you. It looked nothing like this when it was starting off.
But
it turned into this.
Wait, can we take a second? Bella!
It's my crib. And then a fan.
With no light.
Probably do a lot of my homework in here. Probably won't, because we won't be living here, so never mind. I'll probably just come and ask if I can just use the person's den for the day. Thanks.
Come on, this way.
To the front hall closet, you don't want to see what's in here.
So, I also really like this room. It has a lot of, like, I feel like it's really unique. It's not like your traditional dining room, I would say. She's nodding. I guess I'll start with the oriental rug. This rug was the rug I was talking about that we got from my uncle when he gave us my aunt's table. I think what I like about this apartment a lot is the fact that it has a lot of sentimental things in it, like this table. This table was Kay's dad's table, and he like refinished it and fixed it all up. It's beautiful, and it's given us a lot of fun times, a lot of nice dinners and game nights, and it's just awesome. This was our first purchase for our first apartment living together. So birch is one of mine and Kayla's favorite tree. This piece is so beautiful. It holds our records. Then this is the household area for all of our books, mason jars that we use for storage and stuff like that. This record player we got as a gift for Kay for her birthday, her most recent birthday, and it is being used tremendously by all four of us. So, and I think it was a nice gift because it's being used, so. All of the records used to live up on this ledge, and we had so many that like they started to fall, and there was just like an overabundance, and it just looked kind of cluttered up here. I moved them into that cabinet, and then I put all of our either favorite records or the only records that like each of us owned up here, so all four of us have one of our records up here. Then this table, since my parents just moved, they were getting rid of this, so they gave it to us. And I think it'll be perfect for our new apartment. We do have like bar stool chairs that we'll probably replace with these ones. If you watched our empty apartment tour, you'll notice that one of my favorite parts about this Milwaukee apartment is that it has so many hutches in it. And this is one of my favorite ones because it's big and beautiful. But this holds all of our household games. So it looks a mess, but they get used so often. So I don't even care that it's a mess just because everything in there is getting used. These are chopsticks that my dad got from China, and I love them. I think they're beautiful. These are our reusable napkins, and they live over here, and they get used every single day. We'll move on to the kitchen.
Kitchen, island, fridge, mini fridge, all the necessities. So, this kitchen, doesn't have the best lighting. It actually has the worst lighting in the house, except for the hallway. But we spend a lot of time here because we cook a lot. And even though it doesn't have a lot of lighting, we definitely still enjoy the F out of this kitchen. It has like detachments, or like attachments, I should say. So like this is the back door to the stairwell, and this is the door we go out to do our laundry in the basement. This is our little basket full of dirty linens. I think it's cute. It's like one of my favorite things.
Really? Why?
It's just so cute. This mini fridge is basically for like my meals for work. I work extensive hours and bring a lot of food to work. And there was just not enough room in our fridge. And we have this hutch here, another built-in hutch. Plates. See, we're gonna need more plates. Our glasses, cups and stuff. I think that's it. I think we went through the whole house.
Where are you going?
You just follow me.
Sure.
Really enough, so I need you to go.
You're kicking me out.
See you later. Thanks for coming.
Bye.
Bye.
He just elbowed her in the stomach.
So this is the apartment that we lived in for the last year and a half. Been a great time. Like, it's a beautiful apartment. Great neighborhood.
Yeah. If you are new to this channel,
great
again.
Great roommates.
Yeah, they were.
They were.
Like, they're not gonna be our roommates soon. They were great roommates. We love them. There's no bad blood. We still love them. We're still gonna hang out with them. You're still gonna see a lot of them. Yeah, if you're new to this channel and you like this video, please go ahead and subscribe. I upload new videos every single week. And yeah, if you guys wanna see an empty apartment tour of our new place when we move in, which is next month, definitely go ahead and hit subscribe because I will be doing that.
Definitely.
I will see you in our next video. I'm sure Kayla will too. But I love you so much. And
love you too, babe. Bye.
Ay, ay, ay. Bye, guys.
Love bye. You.